You know, Chris, sometimes you just don't have enough buttons on your handset. In this video, we're going to show you how to attach a KEM, a key expansion module. And in this case, it's going to be an appropriate key expansion module for the Cisco 8865 phone.
That's right. So the one we have here is called the Video KEM.
Mm-hmm. Here we go. Get to open up, the Cisco box in this case. And inside, we have what looks like a connector. Some screws, that's good. And then I think we're going to have the KEM itself and the stand. Let's put it all together. Okay, so we've got the pieces. We've got the KEM itself, as you can see, a matching stand, what looks like a connector, and I've left the screws in the plastic because, quite frankly, I don't want to lose them. Let's have a look at the way the KEM is designed to start off with. We've obviously got the connector that will go inside this slot. But as I turn it over, I notice that we've got some ports here that in theory, if I remove them, look like they're for another connector.
That's right. So what you'll find there is that some of the phone models support multiple KEMs. And that's another thing that you would check in the information on the Cisco website or in some of the Tippett guides. They will tell you how many individual KEMs one particular handset can actually carry.
So let's connect it up. Here's a quick tip. You might be tempted to put in the stand first. Actually, what you want to do is to stick in the connector first and then use one of the screws to lock it in place, all right? There's only one way this will go in, and I better get it right. There we go. And you'll probably be able to just see here that there is a screw hole, and that's where one of the screws is. There's a matching one on the handset as well. And then once we put the stand in, you can see it all covers up. Then it's literally a matter of slotting these two together, and we're assembled. So once we plug it in, will it work straight away?
Well, certainly the handset will come on straight away again. Whether the KEM comes on depends upon Tippett's default settings for that handset and the KEM type.
Right.
And sometimes you actually do need to make a change to the custom tags to get the KEM to fire up.
Okay.
And let's make that judgment once we see what happens.
All right, well, let's plug it in, see what happens. There was a flash, and the Cisco logos come up. The line buttons are flashing, and they've all gone green. System's booting. And I can see that the phone is basically back up, but the KEM hasn't been recognised. So why is that again?
All right, what can happen is that the default KEM expectation of the phone within Tippett is a different model to the one that you've plugged in.
Mm.
So what you'll find is that what we need to do is we need to tweak the tags to allow us to actually connect or put in the setting for the right KEM.
Okay.
But the other thing is that if you've got a phone that accepts multiple KEMs,
mm-hmm.
they have a larger power draw.
Right.
And for a PoE or PoE Plus environment, that might mean you need to tweak some custom tags to allow the phone to request more power from the switch.
Okay. All right. Well, let's go in and change the tags.
Sure. Okay. So you can see here that in the Tippett administration portal, I've pre-jumped to you as the user.
Yes.
You can see there on the screen, that's your phone number.
Yep.
So what we're able to do now is go straight to addresses. And for those of you who have watched the custom tag video that we've also produced that explains how tags work. If you check that video, you'll recall how we actually go in and change the setting for one device for one user. All right, so up here at custom tags, we can go in here, and what we're going to do is we're going to add a tag called KEM type. And the reason that I know to do that is because in testing, I've already been through this process.
Right. And again, this is what an administrator is likely to be doing, not a user.
That's right. Yeah. That's right. And a user wouldn't have access to this portal at this level. Okay, the tag value. Now, I know that it needs to be CP8800 video, and that's because it's a video KEM.
Yep.
All right, so I just put that in. I can then press OK. And so that tag is now entered. As you can see on the screen here, that tag is now available to be put into the configuration file for the handset.
Okay.
Now I need to go to the Files tab. I need to rebuild the configuration file. You can see there the comment, after you rebuild the file, be sure to reset the phone for changes to take effect. So mm-hmm. I'm putting the changes in the file by clicking rebuild,
yep.
and then I reset the phones.
Right.
And if we watch the phone, we'll see the line one key flash orange.
Oh, I saw it flash apply configuration, and it seems to be doing it.
Yeah, so this, what you'll find is the reaction of the phone to different types of tags will depend upon, I guess, how significant the tag is to the phone's operation. Sometimes when you make changes in the system, it's a fairly simple change and the phone doesn't go through a large amount of reset work.
Again, it's near real time.
Yeah, it's very close. Yeah. Yeah.
A couple of things I picked up, Chris. If you're an administrator, it would probably be safer if you did all of the tags before delivering the hardware to the user. But if by chance the hardware ends up on the user's desk and they've gone and slotted it in, and then they ring you up and say it's not working, then it's pretty straightforward. And it's near real time again, right?
That's right.
Nice to be able to react quickly, and that's the Tippett environment working again. So can we use it?
Yeah, we can. But what we'll do is use the Tippett admin portal once again to allow us to put in things like speed dials, BLFs, shared call appearances, and other things like that.
Okay, great.